Okay, now we're going to be multiplying rational expressions. We just finished simplifying them, which was just like reducing fractions. This is exactly the same as like multiplying fractions. But actually, it's easier to always factor and cancel before you multiply fractions. And it's going to be the same thing here. So, we have two fractions here. What I want you to do always is put parentheses around each numerator and denominator. Remember, you can only cancel the 8x minus 12 with another 8x minus 12. Don't try to cancel the 8 and the 14 or the 12 and the 7 or the anything else here. It has to be the whole factor. So what we're going to do, this is fun. You just get to do a bunch of factoring, and then what's cool is a lot of it's usually going to cancel. So out of the numerators, I'm just going to write one big fraction. I'm just going to write the factorization of both numerators in the top and the factorization of both denominators in the bottom. All right, all of these are only two terms, so we're going to look for common factors and see if that works. So let's see, out of the top, I could take out a 4 times 2x minus 3 out of the first one. And out of 42x plus 21, I could take out a 21. And that would give me a 2x plus 1. All right, so I've done the numerator. And if you want, you could also write 4 times instead of just putting it in front. All right, now let's do the denominator. 14x plus 7. I could take a 7 out. And I have a 2x plus 1. Wouldn't you know it, there's going to be a common factor. And at a 32x minus 48, the largest factor out of that is 16 times 2x minus 3. Did you kind of guess that maybe it was going to be this 2x minus 3? You kind of think like someone writing a math book. Yeah, that's what's going to happen. Okay, so now let's cancel what we can. I could cancel this whole factor of 2x minus 3 with that whole factor. I can cancel this 2x plus 1 with that 2x plus 1. Now we can also do some canceling with the numbers. The 4 and 16 here, for instance, I could cancel that, and that gives you a 4. And with the 7 and 21, I can cancel that. I get a 3. And I didn't show it here, but with these, they just cancel into 1s, right? That cancels into 1. So, gosh, the only thing is it's kind of messy. Look very carefully at what's left. There's a 3 and a 4. The rest are 1s. So my answer is going to be 3/4. So basically, this original problem was a big messy way of just writing the number 3/4. Interesting way of thinking about it, don't you think? Okay, I want you to try this on your own, put it on pause, and you're going to take all 4 of these, put parentheses around them, get out your scratch paper, factor all 4 of them. These are the easier ones to factor, at least. So when you do that, you should end up with 4 factors in the top, 4 factors at the bottom. See if anything cancels and see what you get for your answer. And then come back and see what you get. Okay, here are your factors. This is going to be x plus 7 times x minus 3. That's how you get x squared plus 4x minus 21. This will be x plus 5 and x minus 4. That gives you x squared plus x minus 20. Let's see, the bottom one, let's see, factors of 28 have a difference of 3, 7 and 4, right? So it's going to be x plus 7 and x minus 4. And the last one, let's see, we're going to have to get x plus 5 and x minus 3. So those are the 4 factors you should have gotten. I just love this problem. It's so much fun. Look at the x plus 7's cancel. X minus 3's cancel. The x plus 5's cancel. And the x minus 4's cancel. Everything cancels. What happens if it all cancels? The answer is 1. Yeehaw! Hey, so this is a really bizarre way of writing the number 1. That's just a more complicated way of doing it. Okay, here's another one for you to try. So try it on your own first. Remember to put the parentheses around all four of the numerators and denominators. Then use factoring methods. Either you're going to be using the difference of two squares in here, you're going to do pulling out the greatest common factor, you're going to have to factor a trinomial into two binomials. So you really are getting good at your factoring skills, I hope. And then see what can cancel from that. Okay, so what do we get here? For x squared minus y squared is x plus y times x minus y. And over here, two terms, take out the greatest common factor, it's 3x. And what will be left is x plus 2. Okay, let's do the bottom now. Two terms, so let's try taking out the greatest common factor, that'll be 3x. And that leaves you with x plus y. All right. And then here we have a trinomial. This one isn't so bad though, because notice the last term is just a minus y squared, so you know it's going to be a y and a y. So we know we're going to have a 3x and a 3x and a y and a y. And because that's the only possibility for 3x squared. So we just have to figure out where to put the minus and plus sign. We want to get a minus 2xy, so it's going to be a minus and a plus. Does that do it? That gives you negative 3xy and a plus 1xy. Yep. Okay, so those are the factors you should have gotten. And now we go across the top to see if we can cancel anything. So x plus y cancels with that. X minus y cancels with the other x minus y. Both the th we have a 3x and a 3x. It could have been just maybe the 3's canceled or just the x's, but actually the entire thing canceled here. 3x cancels with a 3x. And that's it. X plus 2 over 3x plus y is our answer. Resist the temptation to try to cancel these 3x squares right here in the first problem. That's where people make their mistakes. They want to just start canceling before factoring. You must factor before you can cancel anything. Factor first. Okay, here's another one I want you to try all on your own and then come back and compare your answer with how I do it. Okay, put it on pause. Go for it. You back? All right, so let's do the numerator. Nine x plus 18, we could take out a 9. That's x plus 2. All right, now here we're going to have to factor. Now this is where you could do it over on scratch paper someplace. I'm going to just try, let's see, I'm going to try 2x and 2x. Is that going to work? I do not think that's going to work. The reason it's not, because if I put a 6 and 1 or a 3 and a 2, there'll be a 2 in the same parentheses. So I know that's not it. I'm doing it by trial factors, but you could do it by any of the methods for factoring. So I know it's going to be a 4x and an x. And let's see, I think it's going to be 3 and 2. Does that work? Yes. All right, again, I've just factored a lot, so I'm fairly quick at doing it by trial factors, but you can go out to your scratch paper and figure it out any way you want. So let's see. And at the bottom, we take out an x to get 4x minus 3. And for x squared minus 4, it's a difference of two squares. So the rest of them aren't too bad. All right, so what do we do here? All right, there's a 9, and is there any factor down here I can cancel with a 9? No, don't try to cancel with this 3. That's not a factor. 4x minus 3 is the factor. Is there an x plus 2 in the denominator? Yes, I can cancel. Is there a 4x minus 3 in the denominator? Yes, I can cancel. Is an x minus 2 in the denominator? Yes. I can cancel. What's left? 9 over x. So our answer is 9 over x. So that is how we multiply rational expressions. We factor, and then we see if we can cancel anything. So don't just start off trying to multiply. 9x plus 18 times 4x squared minus 11x plus 6. Yikes! Way, way too hard, and then you would get stuck and not know how to factor it. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.